Good morning. Today we have a topic, our direct online starters. So you know that there are various starters like direct online, Star Delta, Auto Transformer. So like this we have one direct online. When you go on board, so then you will find lot of direct online starters. All small motors are using direct online starters. So why do we need a starter? The starter is the protection to the motors. So if anything goes wrong, it will have stop the your motor, avoid from burning the motor. Okay. So now when we see this starter diagram, so this is the 440 volt coming from the main switchboard. Then you have a Q1, this is the fuse isolator. Then you have all three phases and power is waiting at this place. This is the KM1, this is the contactor for this coil, and this is the overload relay or the overcurrent relay. And then you have the motor, three phase motor. This is the 440 volt three phase motor. This is the your control circuit. So the 440 volt coming from here to this step down transformer and to this place. So this Q12, when we are tracing the electrical circuit diagram, so you have the Q12. Q12 means Q1 of this breaker, and 2 line is coming here, and Q16 is coming to this. This means 440 is available to the step down transformer. Now this is stepping down to 220 volt. From 220 volt, this is the control circuit. So this is the step down transformer, secondary winding, 220 volt. This is the control fuses. Through this, power is coming and waiting at this place, and other side it is coming and waiting at this place. So this is the contact for overcurrent relay. This is the stop contact. This is the start contact. This is the running lamp. This is the KM1 contact, and this is holding on contact for KM1. Okay. So the contactor looks like this. This is the 440 volt. This is the KM1 440 volt, and these are auxiliary contacts with the holding on contacts. So when you press this start button, so the power from here coming to this place through stop reset button, through the stop button, through this, and this lamp gets on. So this means your motor indication is showing. Okay. Then power from here, it is coming through this place, through the KM1, and the KM1 gets energized. So KM1 energized, your contactor is pulled in and your 440 volt contactor made. So this is complete. So your motor starts working, start rotating. But same time contact making by this is the holding on contact. Holding contact, this is retaining contact. So the time you stop the start push button, power will through this, instead of this, power is through this will complete to this, and your circuit will remain complete and your motor will keep on running. So this is the remote one, so you press this one or this one, anyone. So your motor will start running and it will keep on working. Okay. So for stopping, when you break this chain, when you push the stop button, this means you are breaking the circuit. And then it will get disconnected. So other faults, like suppose you go and start the motor, you press the push button, motor is not starting, then what happens? The first thing is to check your overload coil or OCR. So overload, all three phases 440 coming, but is the auxiliary contact at this place, F1 OCR, this is to be reset. So this contact will get open and your motor will keep on running with this. Okay. So you have two places, you can start from this or this.